to the first broadcast for FIFA 17. Ladies and gentlemen, we will be doing three series here with FIFA 17. One of them isn't really a series, it's more just pro clubs. Whenever I have enough people to be on and do pro clubs with me, it'll be a lot of fun. I'll enjoy it. I will enjoy broadcasting it, and I hope people will enjoy being on there with me to broadcast it. It's certainly going to be a whole lot of fun. The other two series are My Manager Mode and My Player Mode. This is My Manager Mode. Thank you so much for joining us. Now, if you recall my FIFA 16 videos that are on Twitch exclusively, I'm leaving them on Twitch. I'm not going to move them over. There's no point in my mind to do so. I used Orlando City. Now, even on the old game, on 2016, Orlando City didn't have an audio file. And I said to myself, while I was doing this broadcast, I said in my head that if Orlando City doesn't have an audio file in 2017, I will use them for my player mode. I will not use them for my manager mode. So Orlando City will, of course, be our My Player Mode team in the MLS. We're going to do it in the MLS for My Player Mode. My manager is the MLS teams in the Premier League. So instead of using Orlando for this, I wanted to use a team that had an audio file. I wanted to use a team that I like. We're going to go with Toronto. Toronto FC, they're one of the up-and-coming teams. I think they have a good shot at winning their first ever MLS title this year. They are a very, very good team. They have four domestic cups, but I'm pretty sure that none of them are actually the MLS playoffs championship, because I'm pretty sure they've never made the MLS championship. Now, there's a possibility that those four titles are the Lamar Jackson U.S. Open Championship trophy, where any team can play. Any team that plays in America is allowed to compete in that, and that might be it, but I don't know. So we're here with Toronto because, you see, there's a little bit of a difference, and they don't – actually, some of these do show it. Colorado Rapids is a two-time – champion. Actually, no. One time, my bad, I think. I don't know. Okay, yeah. So, domestic cup was the U.S. Cup. And as you see, the DC United, they've been crowned champions four times. That's actually true. So, that's the way to look at it. The teams usually have their amount of wins above the logo on their jerseys. It's pretty neat. So we have Toronto, who have four domestic cups, which is the U.S. Open Cup. Either way, I'm extremely disappointed that there still isn't an audio file for Orlando City. I mean, it's been since 2015. I could understand 2015 not having it. Okay, they were an update team. They were added in an update, and New York City's in the same boat. I don't even understand that, because you have New York Red Bulls. All you have to do is add City on the end. But whatever. They say New York. They can't say New York City. So I don't know. Orlando, I don't get. But they also don't say, they don't have it for, where is it? Rest of the world. Oh. What? I can't do a rest of the world? Okay. Actually, I know how I can show it, at least. You do the rest of the world. They don't even have Orlando for this team, which I think is from South Africa, maybe? I don't know where they're from, really. But either way, we are going to do Toronto, which makes me happy. They're a decent team, so... we're going to go ahead and move into my manager mode, where I will, of course, use my full name, which is very uncommon for me to do on most sports games, but I don't know why on FIFA it just feels right to use my full name, my full first name. I usually go by Nick, but on FIFA I just feel like it should be Nicholas. I don't know why, for what reason, just don't know. Oh my God, they have Morgan Freeman. I am sure somebody is going to use that and name their manager Morgan Freeman at some point. I'm sorry. That's so wrong, but it seems like so true. So I'm not really a big fan of the options that they have for the managers. I really wish it would have been the full customization, like my player is, which would make the fact that you can retire from my player, it would make more sense then. But you know, new to FIFA 17 is Total Club Management, where we have long-term goals and short-term goals. We have financial objectives of expanding the brand of your club and even growing the youth development program. The importance of each of these categories, you know, they vary between clubs, and Toronto, I think, is more concerned with winning now than they are winning in the future. And we'll see where our goals are for obviously, I want to see if I can go out and maybe sign a player or two, maybe get a better goalkeeper. It's very important to improve the team. We need it. We're absolutely going to try to get into the Premier League in our first season. I don't know if it's going to happen for sure, but we're going to make our best attempt at it. We're going to try to win as many cups as we can, both the Capital One Cup and the FA Cup. So I'm going to put that right over this and same save file that we did last time for FIFA 16. So normally I would say yes to these, but I'm going to go ahead and decline to participate in the preseason tournament. I don't see a really a reason to do so. I'd rather just the team get focused on getting ready for our first season. So the team set a goal. Okay. Well, let's take a look at what our objectives are for the season. Domestic success is low. They hope we finish mid-table, and they want us to reach the round of 32 in the FA Cup. Okay. We have zero objectives for the continental success. Well, because we're not going anywhere near the continental yet. Financial reduced player wages by 11,000 a week. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that. Sign one player in your youth academy assigned to the midfielder position. Probably could do that. And gain 11,000 earnings from shirt sales within a season. So we're going to do our best to meet all of these goals. We have 26 million in our budget, and okay, well, that's nice. It's gonna be a while before I get a financial takeover. I'm gonna actually redeem this and great. Thanks for doing that. Where is my youth academy? Oh, it moved. That's nice. I'm gonna avoid doing that for right now. Maybe next season. Like I said, success is for the future is what I'm looking for. We're gonna start the season against New York Red Bulls. Wow. That's a gonna be a fun matchup. So let's see here. I'm gonna hang on to what we have money-wise. I'm probably gonna look in the second transfer window to maybe improve the team. That seems like the place to go for that is to handle it in the second window and not so much the first window. It'll allow us to make some money in the FA Cup and the Capital One Cup by then. And we have a transfer offer for Armando Cooper. Yeah, why not? Actually, I am going to go out and sign somebody. And I hate that he doesn't have an audio file, but he is one of my favorite players in the entire world. I have his jersey. And he's a hometown boy. He's a Toronto kid. And I mean, why not? Like I said, he's a Toronto kid. He's from Toronto, so I'm hoping that the team will enjoy this. He's a very high scoring player. I'm actually all for that. Absolutely. $6,500, that's something we can easily handle. Man, as you could see in that fun little picture that they just showed there. Oh, wow. Wow. Well then, we're going to try to max this guy out for what our chief executive thinks we can get for him, but for $35,000, this might work out really well for us. Yeah. I'm really hoping it does. First, we're getting Kyle Aaron, which makes me a really happy camper. He's going to get upgrade to $30,000 a year. Or $30,000 a week, whatever. Fine by me. I'm pretty sure that if that other deal goes through perfectly fine, the team is going to hate me. Okay, so we have Kyle Larin now, which, yay. the other deal is done, which is also yay, because that's $35,000. So let's see here. Player is sold. We've given you $30,000 to work with. So as a team, we now have $30,000. I'm going to, of course, we have 50,000 total. I'm going to bring it to 40. And we're going to go to transfers. And we're going to look for a player who in real life is not getting used. And I'm assuming probably will not get used much on here either. And he plays for Manchester United, and he's also one of my favorite players of all time. And I'm sure people already know who I'm talking about. As soon as I find him, he's Wayne Rooney. So we're going to inquire about Wayne Rooney. That would be a big coup for us, picking up Wayne Rooney. $56,000. I don't know if that's going to be possible, Manu. Well, I guess we could see if they'll take it with Bradley. Like I said, I don't know if that's going to work or not. I actually want to see what, how much I'd be. Really? Only 28,000? Wow. Laren is seriously the. Okay. That puts us in a little bit of a bind because, you know, you gotta pay him a little bit more to get him to come down a league and whatnot. And I figured that was what I was gonna hear. Well, I'll drop it to, let's see here. Hopefully this will work. Oh, wow. Yeah, that's not gonna work too well. But let's go actually, hold on. I just thought of that. There we go. Yes. Hey, selling shirts. Okay. So let's do that. And we might even put same guy up for sale. Oh, no. That's way too much. We're not going to need him with Kyle Larin. Let's see if the $4 million might make a difference. Probably not. It's a little sad. If it doesn't, big deal. But we're gonna put Bradley on the transfer list, as well as Altidore. Like I said, I probably figure on using Laren the majority of the season. So anyway. So we have a Spanish player who is a goalkeeper. We'll see how it goes. Okay, that's nice. Still haven't heard back from Man United as we inch closer and closer to taking on. Oh my God. You've got to be kidding me. Oh, please accept that contract before. Oh, come on. Oh, that is so disheartening. Oh, well. Looks like it's just going to be Laren making his debut. What did we need here? 44, right? 44 something. We'll go right there. Alright. 44. I don't know what it was. So we can actually go up to right there. Now, what was it that was his reason he didn't want to sign? Let's take a look. Wow, thanks, Wayne. So I'm going to move to a 4. Yeah, that sounds about right. 4-5-1. Laren on the attack. Altidore will be replaced with that guy. This guy's coming there. Him there. And goalkeeper is R1. Okay. So everybody has their roles. I'm going to put Laren as the penalty kicker. I have a lot of faith in Laren. Really hope Wayne Rooney will sign with us. Probably not, but, you know, it would really help bolster sales. It would do a lot for the team. It'd certainly make us a lot better as a team. So here we go. Brilliant. Middle of the pack finish for us. They think we're going to finish 22nd, which we probably will unless we do get Wayne Rooney. Although, probably not. We do have Kyle Laren. So, it is our first match, obviously. It's going to be interesting to say the least. Our projected lineups look nothing like our actual lineups. And as you can see, Wayne Rooney denied our transfer. Whatever. It's not a big deal. I'm just going to go cry in a corner now because Wayne Rooney doesn't want to come to Toronto. Oh, I'm so joking. Okay. If you're asking why it was set to that, I was playing The Journey and I just felt like trying to score a lot just for the fun of it. See what would happen if I could avoid getting sent out on loan, and you don't. You go out on loan. Doesn't matter if you score 20 goals in the first game. Sucks. But, whatever. we're going to go ahead and start this match. So I will turn it over to the announcers and we're going to have fun.
Hi there, I'm Martin Tyler. With me today, as always, Alan Smith.
Thank you, Martin. Looking forward to this one. Should be a good game.
For you today, we have Toronto against New York Red Bulls.
Well, it's not the best atmosphere, given that the home team were relegated last season. But, you know, you look at the players and coming down a division, they should be able to aim for promotion without question, as long as they don't have a fallout from last when they pick themselves up. They're up against a side here that has been relegated, and it was really disappointing campaign for them last season. So coming into this division, you would expect them still to be at the top if they can only just regroup and get going again.
This is the lineup for the home side. Responsibility for some of those five in midfield to get forward, and I'm sure the main striker won't be isolated, although it looks a bit like that on our screens.
Yeah, he could be a lonely man up top there if he doesn't get the support that he needs, because he is the type of player that does need support. He can't do it all on his own.
And for the away side, this is how they line up for this match. The kind of players that we expect, the kind of performances we expect from the individuals trying to make this formation work.
Yeah, I mean, it can at first glance look cautious, but it just depends on the attitude of the players out there. And once they've got a foothold in this game, they can get a little bit more adventurous and push on.
Enjoy the game.
But when you're a forward and you come into a new club, you know from your own experience, Alan, you want to make a good start. Here's his chance. It's his start today.
Yeah, a goal here would certainly help his cause. It would relax him. You don't want to go 3, 4, 5 games not having found the back of the net.
They should be able to play on a wider front now, Alan, shouldn't they, with the signing of this winger?
Yeah, they were a bit narrow, I thought, previously. So this will widen the pitch a bit. Should be a good addition.
Now he's got the ball, what's he going to do with it? He's got his tackle in, and the ball's gone out now. Now it goes into the wider areas where they've got a winger waiting. So we'll restart with a throw-in. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition, now they're here. And here's the cross. Well, the ball deserved perhaps a better response from his teammates in the middle. The defender got there first, though. To Johnson. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation. He went in well. Michael Bradley. That's how to tackle. We'll see how the team shapes up. They've got a new manager, and this is their first competitive game under him.
Well, a win in his first game will do him the world of good, and he'll want to hit the ground running here.
Well read by the defender. Onto the attack now. It's very good skill. He's made the defender look a bit awkward there. Defender to it first. Bradley. Well, they look promising there in that wide area, but the defender's done well. Veron. Right, Phillips. in strongly. Really trying to use the full width of the pitch here to make some progress. In he goes. Put them in front. And that will be a corner for Toronto. And it's a heading chance now. And a goal! And the goal looks spectacular and is very important.
Yeah, there was some power behind that effort. I think the crossbar's still shaking.
So the first goal, it's 1-0. Felipe. Penalty at San Jose.
It's a penalty for the visitors. He's put the ball down on the spot. Here he comes. It's a goal. It's been scored by Kaká. 25 minutes played. 1-1.
Well, many thanks, Alan McInally, keeping us up to date as usual. And it's a goal here.
Well, it's the dream scenario, scoring on your debut. It takes so much of the pressure off.
It's a great spell for this team. Two goals in rapid succession. The goal, wherever you look at it, it was very well taken. Restarting at 2-0. Right, Phillips. Still going, still striving to attack.
Sometimes, as admirable as it is, you just think, well, maybe save your energy a bit more for attacking rather than closing down.
Well, he's got support here. Patience is the name of the game at the moment. Caught under no challenge by the goalkeeper. Another turnover in play here with that interception. And now the shot! And the goalkeeper got a touch to that. Fine save. It's gone for a corner. Right, Phillips. Terrific stop. Position, they've worked this attack very well into a quite a dangerous, wonderful chance. That's a brilliant goal. Well, that's absolutely fantastic. First appearance for this new club, and he's got two goals.
Incredible, everything he's touching, he's turning to gold here.
Well, he's doubled up here with his second goal, and he took it in excellent style, just like the first one. Well, let's take another look at the goal. Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead. On the attack here, looking for an opening with some good controlled build-up. Slipped past his man now. They were hoping, but it didn't lead to anything, the cross.
Moore.
That's cut out. Here the challenge is a good one. And it's going to be a minimum of 3 minutes to be played of added time. And here's the shot. Corner to be taken. And it's a heading chance now. Work by the goalkeeper. The ball is his and he's made sure he's protected it. Well, there is the referee blowing for half time. It's 3-0 here. So, Alan, what about the first 45 minutes he's played on his debut today?
On top of his game out there, and I'm sure he'll be thinking about grabbing his hat trick in the second half.
You don't often get a first half as one-sided as this one. They've been very good, the team that are leading, of course. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Good through pass. Felipe. And he's got the ball away from him with the tackle. Quick change of possession here. Lawrence doing well to keep the ball. Now Johnson. Well, they're in a good position here. They can't keep it on the pitch, it's gone out for a throw. Johnson. Substitute coming up for the away team. Could be dangerous. Comes in with a tackle. Try to keep you in touch with the transfers as we hear about them. İlkay Gundogan has moved to Manchester City.
Well, it's a fairly big transfer figure, £40 million or thereabouts, and I think this lad won't be affected by it, though. He'll be able to concentrate on his football and show us what he can do.
Veron tried to tackle here, and he's done that. Good forward play from them. Not rushing it here, moving from one side to the other. Played into the middle. Right, Phillips. Well done to them to get one goal back, trying to breathe some life back into this contest. What a strike that is!
Well, I think he's picked him out from that left-hand side. Wonderful delivery.
Really accurate cross.
Oh, it's a brilliant header.
3-1 the scoreline as we restart the game. Goal news from Philadelphia.
It's a goal for Philadelphia Union. 66 minutes played, 2-1.
Well, many thanks, Alan McAnally, keeping us up to date as usual. Attacking well here. Patience is the name of the game at the moment. Captured out in front of goal. Minutes now remaining. Oh,
good strong tackle.
Really strong tackle, and the ball's gone out for a throw.
Sean Wright Phillips, there's some potential in this move.
Really trying to use the full width of the pitch here to make some progress.
Benoit Cheyrou.
Could get his cross in now. Well, the ball deserved. Right, Phillips. Good block. Didn't want it to stop, did they? And the referee's got the sympathy of this match, I think. He understands.
And that's a foul, and they'll get a free kick for that. It's going to be a card. It's going to be a yellow card.
Well, that's the least surprising thing I've seen out there today so far.
They tried to keep it, but they haven't been able to do that. Here's a chance to attack.
To score!
And the goalkeeper has done well to stop that one. 10 minutes left of regular time.
Short passes, but they're keeping the ball.
Got to be. Couldn't keep his balance on this difficult surface.
It's a greasy ball. We've had quite a bit of rain. Not an easy one to control.
Sean Wright Phillips. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition. Now they're here.
Crisp defending there.
There'll be a throw now after the tackle.
Played into the middle, and it's a headed effort at goal,
and behind off the frame of the goal.
What we've got here is the home team winning, but the away team frustrated because it looks like there's a running down of the clock going on here.
Yeah, there's a bit of gamesmanship going on, but you've got to expect that as they try and see out this lead that they've got.
Good slide challenge, that, to regain possession.
The fourth official has indicated there will be a minimum of 2 minutes of any time.
Yeah, the challenge is a good one.
Sean Wright Phillips on the attack here. There's the ball in. They've coped with it well defensively.
And it was close enough to keep the interest right to the end. The final whistle has gone here, and the game has finished at 3-1. First weekend of the season, a great way to start it. They've won, and they've really looked the real deal for the first 90 minutes. Long way to go, of course.
Oh, an awful long way to go, but what a start. The players judging off the pitch, they'll be hopeful of good things this season.
A final of 3-1 in favor of Toronto in my debut and Kyle Aaron's debut. Kyle Aaron puts in 2 goals for the team, and we walk away with a 2-goal victory, basically. We won by 2 goals, thanks to Kyle Aaron, who makes his debut and his homecoming debut. I mean, this was a big deal for him. It's the first game at home for him in Toronto as a member of Toronto. So it was a great game all around. I'm very happy with the end result. As you can see, San Jose defeated Orlando City. Sporting Kansas City beat Philadelphia. The Fire beat New York City. FC Dallas over New England. And yeah.
DC United 1. Columbus Crew,
so our next event is the EFL Cup, which is, I'm assuming, the formerly known as Capital One Cup. It's the only thing I could think of.
Philadelphia Union 1, Sporting Kansas City 2.
Portland Timbers 1, I guess. Aston Villa. I don't know. Queen's Park Rangers 0. I guess that's what it is. It's the only thing that makes sense. So as you can see, we are currently in the transfer spot, the automatic promotion spot, along with Montreal, who's only ahead of us on goal difference. We're tied with Chicago. And it's looking really good for us right now, after one game. Yeah. As you see, Laren shined in his Toronto debut, according to the press. I'm going to rescind the fact that I put Bradley on transfer list, because I don't want him getting transferred while we need him to complete the Wayne Rooney deal, essentially, if we can transfer the other guy, is the hope. So we'll play this match, and then that will be it for us. Let's see here. So there you have it. This week's star performers: Kyle Laren, Michael Bradley, Drew Moore. It was a great day for the Toronto guys. I'm actually surprised that two Red Bull players made the list. Overall, though, like I said, great game from the team. I'm extremely confident ahead of my next match, which, absolutely, why wouldn't I be? We just won our first match. We're going into the EFL Cup. I think we are in a very good spot going forward. So we'll go ahead and handle this. We're once again at home, which is always nice. I don't like that color combo on them in this matchup. So there we go. All right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to the announcers, and let's have a good one again.
It's cup tie time in the English League Cup, and I can sense the extra buzz amongst the supporters as we came into the stadium. For you today, we have Toronto against Stevenage. Could be his game today, the way he's been playing recently.
Two goals in his previous match and two really good ones as well.
Well, this is how the home team shape up. He looks as though the manager's set up a team here. Whatever happens, we're not going to be beaten today.
Does look that way, doesn't it? And I hope it's not a dull affair, this, because we've seen this manager set up teams in the past and just concentrating on a clean sheet.
This is how the visitors shape up. Two banks of four, 4-4-2.
Yeah, how it always used to be. Don't see it quite so often these days, but that's a classic formation and really capable of causing problems here today.
Thank you, enjoy the game.
And this game is being officiated by our referee, Graham Horwood. We're ready to go in this cup tie in the English League Cup.
Well, there's a lot of good players out there, but they don't always show it in this competition because nerves can get the better of you.
Morrow. On to the attack now. In comes the challenge. Well, they passed their way up into a good position here and then just lost the concentration, lost the ball as well. And they've got to work hard to try and get it back. It's gone behind for a goal kick. Michael Bradley made the challenge well. Wells and Kennedy just working away to try and find an opening. It was nicely worked until that point when it broke down. Now they've got to try and regain possession. Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped. One, two, and having a little... And shoots! Great work by the goalkeeper. The ball is his, and he's made sure he's protected it. There's some potential in this move. Referee had a good look at that, decided it's just a throw after the tackle. Osorio. Here the challenge is a good one. Well, the tackle there has led to a throw. Moore. Morrow. Here's a chance to attack. It was good play until they got that challenge in. That was a foul. The referee's allowed the game to go on. He's entitled to do that. In comes the challenge. Michael Bradley. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition. Now they're here. Mackinac. Didn't want it to stop, did they? And the referee's got the sympathy of this match, I think. He understands it, and they're playing on. Really on top of their game now. Wonderful understanding. Patience is the name of the game at the moment. He's lost the ball. Well, the ball deserved perhaps a better response from his teammates in the middle. The defender got there first, though. Oh, well, credit for the effort, the intention, but the technique was poor. And now he's going to sort out that earlier incident and book the player who committed the foul.
Yeah, he doesn't miss much, this ref. He's eagle-eyed, and he wanted to give the team a chance to move forward, but always going to produce the yellow for that.
Crosses in. Well, the ball deserved perhaps a better response from his teammates in the middle. The defender got there first, though. And in comes the header, and here's the shot. Got in the way. They can't get it away. Corner again. And it's a headed effort at goal. And they've taken the lead here. Superb goal here.
Well, the attention to detail from the coach on these kind of set pieces, he's faultless. He'll be delighted with that.
So the first goal, it's 1-0. Wells. The manager will go into this with extra zest, really. Played 1-1. What's going to happen in game number two?
Well, results are evident.
Shots on here. And that's a brilliant goal. Well taken.
Oh, that was scoreboy stuff. Having just scored, they concede at the other end. Lack of concentration.
Well, the equaliser has happened. Took perhaps the opposition by surprise, but we're level again. It's what they've deserved. It is level. Goal. Both sides have scored here now.
The scorer, number 14, Ben Kennedy.
Michael Bradley. On to the attack now. Through pass. And the cross is in. Well, the ball deserved perhaps a better response from his teammates in the middle. The defender got there first, though. Decision is a throw. It was a fair tackle. Fox. Throw in to come. Well, they're in a good position here. Comes in strongly. It's out. It'll be a throw. From the referee by the fourth official, that's the decision regarding added time. Bradley. There's some potential in this move. There goes the cross. Not a great cross at all in the circumstances, and pretty easy to cope with by the defending team. And that's the half-time whistle from the referee. 1-1 at the break. I think that's a good performance, isn't it, Alan, from him in the first half?
Well, he stepped forward for his team there with that equaliser, but his team haven't been, what you would say, on the best of form.
Well, he's going to have a go, isn't he, with this substitution, the manager. It's definitely an attacking move to try and get a winning goal. Good action in the English League Cup in the first 45 minutes. Second half starts now.
I think one or two players surprised us, actually, how well they played in that first half. They'd be delighted.
Trying to find a way through here, probing away. And they're keeping the ball now. The shot's on!
And that is now a goal kick.
Let's put you in the picture regarding Paul Pogba and his deal done now. It's confirmed he has moved to Manchester United.
Exciting deal this for the fans and for his teammates. Around £70 million. Money well spent, I think.
Short passes, but they're keeping the ball. Gone for the through pass. Comes out with a punch to clear the danger. That's a good idea with the... And shoots! What a goal here! And it puts them into the lead.
What a strike that was. It's just arrowed into that right-hand side of the goal.
And that's a goal well worth analysing again. Go again, 2-1. Wells. There's going to be a substitution. It's for the away team. Well, this is great teamwork, the way they're knocking the ball around. Doing well to keep the ball. Well, that's good support play from his teammates. Through pass. Will be kicked to the goalkeeper. Goal kick.
Coming off the pitch, number 8, Stephen Schumacher. Coming onto the pitch, number 22, Charlie Lee.
What we've got here is the home team winning, but the away team frustrated because it looks like there's a running down of the clock going on here.
Yeah, there's a bit of gamesmanship going on, but you've got to expect that as they try and see out this lead that they've got.
Good football between these two. Nice passing. Wilkinson. Now Johnson. Jose Altidore. Challenges for the ball. Jose Altidore. He's coming forward with some danger. Tackling is a real skill. Good passing, shrewd passing, accurate passing. That's the way he earns his living. Good awareness by the referee to play the advantage here. Still 20 minutes to go. Jose Altidore. Lee. Great passing, and the crowd really enjoying it, working hard just to see maybe a sight of goal. We could do a better cross than that, I think, and it was easy to cope with. Jose Altidore comes in with a tackle. Benoit Cheyrou. Jose Altidore. Well, this attack has got a bit of menace to it. That looked very good indeed, but the move has broken down. First touch was poor. Penalty! No doubt in the referee's mind about the penalty. And also, no doubt about the colour of the card, it's yellow.
Yeah, maybe a little bit relieved that he wasn't seeing red there, but the referee, I think, has made the right call.
Activity on the bench for the losing team. A substitute getting ready to come off.
Everybody expecting that one to find the back of the net. What a glorious opportunity wasted.
We've got 8 more minutes of the 90. Michael Topp. It's looking good, this move. Good challenge. Bradley. Well, we've had some chances, Alan, but it's a while since we've had a goal. They've still got the lead.
Yeah, and they're knocking the ball about with a fair bit of confidence, and they look pretty secure with this lead at the moment. That could soon change, though, of course.
Very weak challenge, and the cross coming in. Well, they've wasted that crossing position, haven't they? Easily cleared. Came in with the challenge, and the ball broke free. Jose Altidore. 3 minutes from the referee via the fourth official. That's the decision regarding added time. Cut off! That's got it. Off the goalkeeper indeed. Came close to goalkeeper, actually did get a touch on it. But I think it was a pretty good effort to do that much. Well beaten, really.
Yeah, I don't think you can blame the keeper, Martin. He's looking at his defenders. Why was the lad given so much space?
Just a reminder, 3-1 it is now, the scoreline. Enough to keep the interest right to the end. The final whistle has gone here and the game is finished at 3-1. Well, in cup ties, winning is all that matters, and they have won.
Yeah, they've done the necessary. I think they just about deserved it. It was close at times, but yeah, they're winners here.
What a brilliant performance from this fella.
Well, he was certainly the man to watch for the opposition, but they could do nothing to tame him. Got himself a brace to contribute to this win.
Another two-goal game for Kyle Larin, who does fantastic yet again for Toronto FC, as I was about to say Orlando. Larin looked fantastic. He got us multiple chances. Once again, we subbed in Jose Altidore there for a little bit, and he helped us out. And no matter what, everything started to go the right way for us. That's going to do it for the games that we're going to play. We're going to go ahead and advance to the next game. We're not going to play it, and I'm not going to sim it. We're going to play it tomorrow. It's about 3:16 in the morning for me. So it is extremely early. Way too early for me to still be up. Fleetwood Town 1, Millwall 2 after extra. So let's go ahead and send to this, see what we get from Wayne Rooney, if he responds or if he's going to wait. Looks like he's going to wait. So let's take a look at what we're dealing with here in terms of the calendar. Wow. So we have Houston, then Columbus. Okay, well, this is going to be fun. So let's just take a quick look at our schedule. Wait. Wow, that is unlucky. That is an unlucky draw, if you ask me. So then we have Newcastle United, Philadelphia Union, Galaxy, Fire. It's going to be a lot of fun. Wait, where is the Whitecaps game? Oh, it's at home. Where was the Newcastle United game at? Home. Yay. Let's check Norwich City. Home. Queen's Park Rangers. All right, it's an away game. Yay. And Seattle's an away game. Cool. Then there's the away for Norwich, which means Real World Stadium. Second transfer window, so this should be useful for us right in that area. Let's see here. Who do we end the season with? San Jose. Okay. Wait, seriously? Oh, okay. Championship Sunday. All right. Fair enough. So that's the schedule, guys. Personally, I like where we're going. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be great. And I can't wait to see where we go in the future with this wonderful series that we're doing here, the My Manager series. Wait. Oh, up to 199 in wage budget. All right. So we're going to make sure that we save it. There we go. And as you can see, I've been doing the journey a little bit. If you guys want to see that, make sure to give us plenty of likes. And we'll make sure to get to it. I mean, if I see that people want to see the journey, I will absolutely do it. But until I see that people actually want it, I'm not going to do it. That's just the way it's going to be. But like I said, if people want to see it, I'll do it. I don't have a problem with doing it. Let's just see what we can do. Maybe if I can get 200 likes, I'll do the journey on this video. So if I can get 200 likes on this video, I'll do the journey on a series for the journey. Yeah. Thank you guys so much. If you've enjoyed this, give it a like, obviously. Subscribe and follow us on Twitch at @Nick_Gylas, where all of these videos are done live. Thank you so much for joining us, guys. It's a pleasure to bring it to you.